The challenge of this video is to create this clean design, and we also want to create here the sliding, and then we have here this great looking transition. And everything has a nice and clean look, and it's a minimal design, so let's get started. This video is sponsored by Invoice Ninja. Invoice Ninja is one of the largest open source platforms for invoicing. If you search for something to manage your invoices with Flutter and handle also your online payments, this service might be something for you. And to get started with this Invoice Ninja plugin, you find the link in the description box of this video. First of all, we like to create here this card widget with an image and a title and also the stars here at the bottom. Therefore, I have created here this movie card widget, and here inside we get started by adding some padding. Then we add a container, and here inside we want to set the decoration, so the card will be the color of white. And we also want to have here at the top some rounding, and therefore we add here this border radius inside, and I put here the top left corner and top right corner rounded, and then we put here basically our card content inside. So I have here a column, and the first thing what we want to display here is an image. So we first of all want to put this image inside, and then also the title at the bottom. So we create here a new method, build image, and here inside of this method we simply create this image asset, and we take here the URL of our movies, and I have created here an asset list with all of our images, and I have also included them in the pubspec jaml file here at the bottom. And now we have here this image, and we want also to wrap here a clip rect around so that we can make it rounded. And then we also want to add here some padding and some margin. And that's it for the image. Then we want to add some space after the image, and we also want to add here the movie name inside. And we center it. Again, some space, and then we build here the different topics of our card. So first of all, the genre. And here we simply create a row of all of our genres. And basically we have here in this case crime and drama, like you can see below the title. And therefore we go here first of all over all the genres of our movie, and we want then to build this little card. So I add here some padding and a container. And here inside we put some decoration of our card, so we want to basically make our card rounded. And we also give here some border to the card, so we have here the gray border. And then we have here exactly this gray border under the title, what you see in this box. And then we want to add here the content of this card. So I put here basically the text inside, which has the same gray color as the border. And also we put here the genre as text inside. And now if I hot reload, we have here these little cards already. And now is the goal to add here after the genres again some space, and now comes the rating. And the rating, we build here some stars. So let's create this method also. And here inside, we basically create again a row. And inside of this row, we first of all put the rating of our movie as a string. Then we have here, for example, 9.0 as a rating. And after it, we have some space. And then we want to put the stars inside. And it's pretty simple. We simply take here this list generate method and put here all the stars of our movie inside, and then we generate X icons. So in this case, for this movie, it's 4 icons which we are generating here. And after the rating, we have some text. So we have here dot dot dot, and that's all what we need for the card. And now comes the important part to create actually the sliding. So we slide here to one direction, and it will come from the other direction also here as a top image. And this gives it a cool effect. And now here at the homepage, we have already created the movie card widget, and now it's the time to actually put here our list view around. And we want to use here, therefore, this carousel slider. It's a kind of list view, and you need to put here in your pubspec jaml this carousel slider inside. And here we basically have a lot of items, so we put here all of our movies inside, which we have created. And therefore I have created here a whole movie list, and we have here different fields which we have to fill. And the carousel slider also takes here another option, so we also need to put here some options inside. And now if I hot reload, it looks already like this, so there's a dramatic change. And here inside of this carousel options, we put first of all that we don't want to scroll infinitely, and we also set here the viewport fraction. And now you see already here that we have on the right side some cards because of this viewport fraction which we have set inside. And we also want to set here height for this card, so we want to get the height here back of our image. And we also want to enlarge the center page, so the center page will always be larger than the other pages, and then we have here this cool effect that the other one is sliding in. And inside of this options you also have here this on page changed, and here we basically want to use our controller, our page controller here at the top. And this controller will later care that it is here sliding at the top this different images also in the background. So we put here first of all the index inside of our current page, and we also define here how long our animation should last, so for 1 second. And now we also need to add later the background so that we see what is going on here. And now we simply put here, instead of this same movie every time, we put here a different movie every time inside. And now if I scroll here through, then we have here every time a different card which you see here. And the next step will be to add here this background so that we have here our sliding, and in the background will also change. So the first thing is to actually wrap this carousel slider inside of a stack, and we also want to align the carousel slider to the bottom, and therefore I set here bottom center inside. And now we want to actually add the background. So I create here a new widget, background widget, and here inside we put our page controller inside. And for this new background widget, we have here our controller which is going here inside. And now we want to build a page view builder to actually scroll between the different items which we have. And here inside we set some properties, so we set the reverse, we set the physics to never scrolling, and we put our controller inside, which is the most important thing to do. And then we want to show all our movies, so I add them here to the item count, the length of our movies. And this is again here the list of all of our movies. And now we build here this item. So first of all we get here the individual movie over our index. And then we call here build background, and here we put our movie inside to actually build the page of one movie. And here we simply show our movie, so we get here over our movie the image URL, and we put it into our image widget. And then we want to put here also the effect inside. So basically you see here this large image in the background, and you see that it is here some effect at the bottom which we also want to add. So here to the bottom it's getting white, and here at the top it's not white, and that's what we can easily add. But first of all I go here over our image and put the image to the whole width of our screen and to the whole height of our screen. And now it looks already like this, so we have our image here in the background. And to add this white effect we put here another container inside, and we put it above our image. And here we simply put a decoration inside, and the important thing is to set here the gradient. And we want to make use here of a linear gradient. And here we put inside the begin and end, so it should begin here at the top center and it should go to the bottom center, this effect. And then we add here some stops inside, and also the colors, which is also really important. And here we put first of all a color with an opacity at the top, and at the bottom we put a right color inside. And now if you hot reload it looks like this. So here we have almost no white color, and here we have a lot of white color. And with the stops you can also play here around, so for example if you set here 0.5 inside, you see that we have here much more first color, and then comes the second color. And you also can delay the second stop, so you can set here for example a higher value inside, so 90%, and then you see that it is here a different effect already. So just for you, if you want to play around with these values, then you simply can have a tremendous effect if you simply change here some colors or some stops. And now if we slide here to a different page, you already see this effect. So we have here some image which is sliding in, and our swiping is always to the reverse location to which we are swiping, and this gives it a cool effect. And if you want to get the whole source code, you can get it with the first link in the description. And with the second link, you can get my Flutter courses where I teach you how to become a better and more efficient Flutter developer. And now we need to go here on and create the finishing of our design. So basically we create here this button, and also on the left and right corner, we create here these two things, and it's really quick. So we go here to our homepage, and we want to set here first of all the extend body behind app bar, and then we also want to set our app bar, and here we basically set only the icon at the beginning and also at the end. So this is our action icon and also the leading icon of our bar. And the important thing is also to make this app bar transparent. And now we also build here this buy button at the bottom. So what we are doing here is we put our carousel slider into a column, and after our carousel slider we put the button inside this buy button widget, because this should never change the position if we slide, and therefore we are not putting it into our movie card widget. And this buy button I simply paste inside because it's pretty simple. So simply we create here a raised button and we give it some height and width, and that's all what we need to do here. So I can hot restart, and you see if I hot reload it looks like this, and you see that the design gets a bit messed up. So in the column we also want to add the main axis size to min, and now everything looks fine again. And now if we are scrolling here through our app, you see that this card will always change and the buy ticket button will stay at this position. And this gives it a nice and clean look for our minimal design. And as a hint, Invoice Ninja has built an app with Flutter for managing invoices. And this Flutter app is open source, and you can check it out, this app and also the source code, on GitHub.
Hello everyone, thank you so much for watching this video. Please make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel here to get the latest news about Flutter. And see you soon, bye.